Hey YouTube, it's Jonathan, and today I'm going to be talking about some basic nail care for men, or really anybody. I'm gonna go over some basic, simple steps and some of my favorite products for keeping my nails looking as nice and clean as possible. The first thing you're going to need, I think, is the most important. This is a basic nail file. I chose a black one when I was in the store just because that's me and I'm boring, but they come in all shapes, colors, sizes, whatever you want. I picked one with a medium grit on one side and a fine grit on the other. The coarser the grit, the faster you're going to get your nails filed, but it can also kind of make your nails jagged if you're using too coarse of a grit, so I choose one that's medium on one side just to kind of get the length down, and then with a fine grit on the other side to kind of smooth the edge. I also have this kind of nail file. I don't use it for actually filing my nails. I really just use the pointed tip on this to clean out underneath my fingernails. If you can't be bothered to file your nails, or you just don't want to do it as often as it needs, then grab yourself a pair of nail clippers. I got this. I really like investing in a good pair of nail clippers because I do find the sharper the better, and the spring action on them is a little bit better and more clean if you have a nice pair. I think it's always super important, especially in the winter time, to keep a little bit of cuticle cream or cuticle oil with you. This is my favorite. It's the Lemon Butter Cuticle Cream from Burt's Bees. I absolutely am obsessed with this. It has saved my cuticles on many occasions. It's very creamy. You just open the top, rub your finger in there, and just rub it along your cuticles. It keeps them moisturized and it smells delicious. And the last thing that I like to do is apply a bit of hand cream. I use this morning and night. This one smells like lavender, which is one of my favorite scents. You can use an unscented version or find one that smells like something you like. If you have peeling or flaking nails, they might need a little bit of extra love. These are two of my favorite nail treatments. This one from Orly is their BB cream for nails. It is lightly tinted. It's not going to look like nail polish, so don't be afraid of this one. It's really great at moisturizing your nails if you have drier, flakier nails, as well as this one from Butter London. It's the Horsepower Nail Fertilizer. It really helps to strengthen your nails and help them to grow. If you do end up going for a paint-on nail treatment, make sure you keep a little bit of polish remover and cotton around. I like to use one that is nourishing for my nails. This has vitamin E in it to soften cuticles and natural nails. I really like to use this rather than a straight acetone or a really harsh one, just because I'm not using a glitter polish or anything that's hard to take off. So this will get the job done and keep my nails soft at the same time. The first thing that I'm going to do is use a little bit of the polish remover on a cotton pad just to take off the tiny bit of the BB cream treatment that I had on my nails before. Once I have everything taken off, I am then going to assess the situation. Do I need to use the clippers or can I just get away with the file? My nails are short enough right now that I can just go ahead and file them down to the right shape. Once you have all your nails filed down to the right length, I then take the pointed file and I just go ahead and run that right under my nails to make sure there's nothing hiding underneath them. Sometimes I do this under the sink if I feel like they need like a really good clean. You can also use a nail brush for this step if you prefer. You can then go ahead and apply a little bit of your cuticle cream. I'm just warming this up with my finger and then applying it and rubbing it right into the edge of my cuticles. After about a minute, the cuticle cream will be soaked in enough that you can apply your hand cream. I squeeze out a dollop on the back of my hand, rub the backs of my hands together because that's where they're dry the most, and then I just go ahead and rub my hands together and apply it everywhere. If you're not going on to use a nail treatment, then you are done right here and right now. Your nails are going to look nice and clean and hopefully stay that way for a couple of days. I usually find that I need to go ahead and redo this every 5 to 7 days, depending on how fast my nails are growing. If you're going to be using one of the nail treatments, now is the time. Wait till all of your cuticle cream and your hand cream has soaked in. I usually wait about 20 minutes before I go ahead and apply any nail treatments. But if you can't wait, you can go ahead and take a little bit of the nail polish remover and just run it across your nails to make sure there's no oils on them. If you do have any oils on your nails, the polish or the treatment won't adhere correctly. Once your nails are prepped, go ahead and apply 2 very thin coats to each nail, one hand at a time. I find that applying the 4 fingers first and then applying the thumbs at the end is the best way to do this without smudging or getting the treatment everywhere. But once you have everything applied, let it dry, and then you are done. All right, well, I hope you all enjoyed my simple nail care for men, or really anybody, video. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment below if you have any questions about nail care or any ideas for future videos. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already. You can click on my face right now to go ahead and do that. Check me out on Instagram and Twitter. Both of those things are at JohnJohnTalks, and I will see you all next time. Bye. Quite as natural. And I used this, and I have already purchased another bottle. I just spray a little bit in my wet hair before I blow dry it, and it kind of helps to naturally lighten it over.